Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Prakashananda Saraswati, they are now together. Now there will be discussion. Now, Prakashananda Saraswati is asking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I think your name is Sri Krishna Chaitanya, and you are disciple. You have accepted this renounced order of life from Keshav Bharati. As I have explained to you, that there are 10 different names in the Sankar Sampradaya of the Sannyas, and there are 108 names amongst the Vaishnava Sannyas. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, although he was initiated by Vaishnava, he took sannyas, he accepted sannyas from Bharati, who belongs to the Sankar Sampradaya, Sankar sect. The rule is that if one has to accept renounced order of life, there is ceremony, as there is ceremony of initiation, there is ceremony of accepting this renounced order of life, and that ceremony must be performed by another bona fide sannyasi, renounced order. It is not that you take your cloth and get it collared and one day you become a sannyasi. No, there are ceremonies. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas from Keshav Bharati. This Keshav Bharati belonged to Sankar Sampradaya. Therefore, Prakashananda Saraswati also belonged to Sankar Sampradaya. So he is asking that, I understand that your name is Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Now there are different kinds of names of brahmachari also under the guidance of a sannyasi. So the person who is under the guidance of Bharati, the brahmachari's name is Chaitanya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, although he took sannyas, he did not change his brahmachari name. That is also very significant. Because in the Mahavadi sannyas, as soon as they take sannyas, they think that I have become Narayan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, although he was regularly a sannyasi, he did not change his name of brahmachari. That means brahmachari is meant for serving the spiritual master. So he continued to be a servitor. That is the significance. So Prakashananda Saraswati is asking that you are a sannyasi of our sampradaya because you have accepted renounced order from Bharati. So what is the reason that you do not mix with us? That is his first question. And another complaint is that you are a sannyasi, you should devote your time in discussing philosophy, Sankhya philosophy, and Vedanta Sutra. You should learn, you should understand why you have taken sannyas, and what is this that you are simply dancing and chanting, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. This was his first question, yes. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was simply dancing and chanting. This is the specific contribution of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because amongst the Mahavadi sannyasi, dancing and chanting is considered to be material. That is also, they take, it is also one kind of sense gratification. A sannyas means they should stop sense gratification. So this is also, according to them, sense gratification, because they took it as ordinary singing. So Prakashananda Saraswati asked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, why do you follow this sentimentalism, chanting and dancing? And some of the foolish persons who have no knowledge, they also follow you. What is this? Vedanta Patan Dhyan Sannyasidhan. You have taken sannyas, renounced order of life. Your duty is to study Vedanta always and meditate. Tahachari karakano bhavukana. You have given up all these procedures and you are simply chanting and dancing. Prabhava dekhi tamaya sakhadar. So far I see you from your bodily features. Oh, you appear to be very glorious. You are very intelligent. Because he was born, Prakashananda Saraswati was very elderly, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was only 24 years old. So he is appreciating that from your face it appears that you are very learned, advanced. Then why do you indulge in this sentimentalism? This is very important question and answer you should know, this Sankirtan movement. Hinachar karo kane thiki karan. So this is not deserving to a sannyasi. Prabhu kaya suno sipadi har karan. Guru more dukh murkha dekhi karila shashan. Yes, you are right, my dear Prakashananda Saraswati. You are right. But there is reason why do I do it. Now I can explain to you. When I took sannyas from my Guru Maharaj, from my spiritual master, he found me a rascal, and fool number one rascal. So Guru Maharaj murkha dekhi karilo shasan. So because he found me a foolish person, therefore he has chastised me. Why? What is that? He said, murkha tumi, you are foolish, you have no education, you are illiterate. Tomara nahi vedanta adhika. It is not possible for you to understand Vedanta. Krishna mantra japa sada ehi mantra sara. Therefore, you simply chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. That will make you all right. Now here is the point, that was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu a foolish person? No, he was not a foolish person. In his childhood, he was known as Nimai Pandit, the greatest learned man. Even when he was 16 years old, he defeated another very learned fellow from Kashmir. So he was a reputed scholar. And he was known, and Prakashananda Saraswati knew it, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, even in his grihastha ashram or in his household life, he was a teacher of nay, logic, and he is a great learned man. He knew it. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that my spiritual master found me a rascal, a fool. Therefore, he said that you have no chance for understanding Vedanta. Therefore, you take to this principle, chant simply Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. What is the purpose of presenting himself as fool and rascal? The idea is that in this age, 99.9% are fools and rascals. Therefore, it is very difficult for them to understand what is the purpose of Vedanta. He is representing himself as one of the fools and rascals. So, according to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the so-called Vedanta societies, the so-called I mean to say, and learned scholars and Vedanta, they are not actually Vedanta scholars, they are all fools and rascals. Because Vedanta Sutra is very difficult to understand. The compiler, the author of Vedanta Sutra is Vyasadeva. He himself thought it wise that I must leave one commentation of Vedanta Sutra, otherwise in future people will misunderstand and misuse Vedanta Sutra. In this connection, I may declare herewith that some of you, if you read the Chicago speech by Vivekananda, he was the first man, he came from India to preach this Hindu philosophy in 1893, some of you know. So he has got his speech, Chicago speech of Vedanta. You will see, it is simply rascalism, simply. My speech is written. If you can secure, you bring it, you will see how rascalism he was. You will be surprised. Even a clergyman from this country, he was surprised. Oh, you come from India and you are decrying God in this way? Oh, I'm surprised. He was simply as declared God. Oh, why do you care for God? Throwing God, you are God in this way. He has spoken. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 500 years before, he knew it that in future all these rascals will misinterpret Vedanta Sutra. Therefore he presented himself that I am fool. Vedanta Sutra is not a very easy thing. Therefore Vyasadeva, he explained Vedanta Sutra and Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam, the first aphorism of Vedanta Sutra is Janmadasya Jataha Adhat Brahma Jignyasa. Now it is the time for understanding what is Brahma. And the next sutra is, what is Brahma? The next answer is Janmadasya Jataha. Brahma is that from whom or from where everything emanates. Now he explains Janmadasya verse. Janmadasya Jataha Annayat Itaratascha Arthesu Avignya Sarat Tini Brahma Rida Adikavai Mahyanti Yat Suraya. In this way, there is a lucid explanation of Vedanta Sutra. Now if you take Vedanta Sutra, this Janmadasya aphorism, that Brahma is that absolute truth from where everything emanates, or everything is born. Janma means born, birth, and sthiti means maintenance. And janmadi, janma, sthiti, and pralaya. Pralaya means dissolution. This material world, it has got a date of its creation, just like your body. It has got a date of its creation. It stays for some time, and again there is a date of its dissolution. You take the history of everything material. Either you take this body, or take this world, or take any empire, or any, just like your American country. It has a date of its beginning. Now it is staying. Now it will be, someday will come, there will be no more America. You should know it. That is nature's law, everything. Everything is born, it stays for some time, then it is dissolved. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhutya bhutya praliyate. Bhutya-bhutya-paliyate. All these things, whatever material that manifests, it comes out, it is manifested, is just like bubbles in the ocean. Oh. There are millions and millions bubbles created 1 second, and then it's next second it is finished. So, janmādhasya-jata. But this is the manifestation of material creation. Behind this, spirit is there. Therefore, that spirit is Brahma. In this way, now, what is the nature of that Brahma? Is it impersonal or personal? Now, Vyasadeva says, avijñā-sarāt. No, that Supreme Truth is cognizant. He knows. And Bhagavad Gita also confirms that vedāṁ samititāṇi, the Lord says that I know everything. I know, unless he is cognizant, unless behind this cosmic manifestation, if there is no brain, if there is no cognizance, how nicely it can be made so regulation, timely, everything is working, the planets are working. Do you think there is no brain behind it? There must be. Therefore, Bhagavat says there, yes, avijñā. Avijñā means he is cognizant. He is not a fool. Therefore, he is person. A cognizant is a person. And it is said, sarāt. Then he also educated Brahmā. He also, because Brahmā is considered to be the first created being in this universe. So Bhagavad says, tene brahmarida adikavai. Adikava means the first created being. And Brahma means Vedic knowledge. So he impregnated Brahma with Vedic knowledge. So these are the explanation of Vedanta Sutra. There are so many foolish rascals that misusing Vedanta Sutra in a different way. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very cunningly represented himself that I am a fool, I am a rascal. Therefore, my Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master, chastised me that you rascal, you fool, you cannot understand Vedanta Sutra. You better take this, that will make you happy. Or in other words, at the present moment, the circumstances are so awkward that it is not possible to understand Vedanta. If you indulge in Vedanta Sutra, it will be very difficult for you. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's contribution, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, just chant Hare Krishna. That will make you everything progressive. The murkha to me, tamara nahi vedanta dhukar. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is representing himself as the chief man of the fools and rascals, and he says that my Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master, ordered me that you better chant Hare Krishna, that will make you happy and progressive. That will make you one day understand what is Vedanta. Krishna mantra haite habe samsar mach. Now one may question, Vedanta Sutra. Understanding Vedanta Sutra, one is liberated from this material entanglement. So you are asking me simply to chant Hare Krishna. Will that purpose be served? His Guru said, yes, it will be served. He said, Krishna mantra haita have samsar mach. If you go on continuing this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, there will be a day when you come to the perfectional stage, then you will be liberated. The same result as one gets out of studying Vedanta philosophy or Sankhya philosophy, the same result also you will get by simply by chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna nam haite pave Krishna charan. Not only that, the Vedantis sometimes they cannot reach up to the Krishna planet. But your advantage will be that you will not only be liberated, but you will be achieving the highest planetary kingdom or the kingdom of God. You will be able to achieve there. And nam bina kuli kale nahi ardharma. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained that this Hare Krishna is the only universal religious principle in this age. No other religion process will be effective because people are so many and diverted in different ways. This is the common formula and this is the effective formula. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Nam bina kuli kale, without chanting this Hare Krishna, there is no other alternative for self-realization in this age of Kali. Nam bina kuli kale nahi ar dharma, sarva mantra sar nam ei shastra marma. Now, the essence of all scripture is this Hare Krishna. Essence. Sarva Shastra Manma means essence of all scripture. And Sarva Mantra Shastra. And there are different kinds of hymns and mantras. And this is the this is the topmost part of our mantras. In this way, my Guru Maharaj asked me to chant Hare Krishna. Atavali Yak Slok Shikhai Dogmati. A dictator, because one cannot be a guru or spiritual master if he creates something. No, he cannot create. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says to Prakashananda Saraswati that my Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master, has reason. Why? What is the reason? Kanthi kari ehi slok kariyo vichare. My Guru Maharaj said, he gave me one verse from authoritative Vedic literature and he asked me that you should always keep this verse within your, throat. That means, keeping in throat means, and what is that? This is a quotation from the Vedic literature, Bihan Naradiya Purana. There are four Vedas and there are supplementary Vedas also. There are 18 Puranas. So one of the Puranas is called Brihat Naradiya Purana. So in that Brihat Naradiya Purana, this quotation is there. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Iva Kevalam, Kalau Nasti Va Nasti Va Nasti Va Gadinannatha. In this age of Kali, Kali means disagreement, quarrel, and misunderstanding. This is Kali Yuga. Misguiding, and less intelligent, less merciful, living for short period. There are so many disqualifications in this age. So, therefore, in the Brihat Naradiya Purana, it is explicitly stated that Harannama, Harannama, Harannama iva kivalam, kalau nasti va nasti va nasti va gati randatha. Kalau means in this age of Kali, there is no other alternative, no other alternative, no other alternative. Thrice. When you want to stress upon some point, you say thrice. Do this, do this, do this. Similarly, in the Brihat Naradiya Purana, thrice it has been emphasized that you must take to this Hare Nama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Why I must take it? No, because there is no other alternative than this for your self-realization. If you at all want to know yourself, if you at all want to become perfect, or if you want at all to reach the goal of human life, then you must. Huh? So my Guru Maharaj, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that my Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master, asked me to keep this verse within your throat and you go on chanting and I bless you that you will be liberated. You will not only be liberated, but you shall also reach the highest goal, the Krishna planet. So we shall explain further. Any questions?